Welcome to Grab and Go Info. T-Learner is a meta-learner that uses two machine learning models to estimate the individual-level heterogeneous causal treatment effect. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to use the Python package CausalML to build a T-Learner. We will cover how to implement T-Learner using the XGBoost model, the light GBM model, and the neural network model separately, how to make individual treatment effect and average treatment effect estimations using a T-Learner, how to check the T-Learner feature importance, how to interpret a T-Learner uplift model using SHAP. If you are interested in building a T-Learner manually, please check out my previous tutorial T-Learner Uplift Model for Individual Treatment Effect in Python. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import the Python libraries. Firstly, let's install CausalML. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Synthetic data is imported for synthetic data creation. XGBT regressor, MLPT regressor, base T regressor, LGBM regressor, and XGB regressor are for the machine learning model training. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the T-Learner Uplift model. Firstly, a random seed is set to make the synthetic dataset reproducible. Then, using the synthetic data method from the CausalML Python package, we created a dataset with 5 features, 1 treatment variable, and 1 continuous outcome variable. After that, using value counts on the treatment variable, we can see that out of 5,000 samples, 2582 units received treatment and 2418 units did not receive treatment. Finally, we get the true average treatment effect by taking the mean of the true individual treatment effect. The true average treatment effect is about 0.5. In step 3, we will use the XGBoost model with T-Learner to estimate the average treatment effect and the individual treatment effect. XGBT regressor is a built-in XGBoost T-Learner model that comes with the CausalML package. To estimate the average treatment effect using XGBT regressor, we first initiate the XGBT regressor, then get the average treatment effect and its upper bound and lower bound using the estimate8 method. We can see that the estimated average treatment effect is 0.61, which is 0.11 higher than the true average treatment effect. The lower bound for the average treatment effect is 0.56 and the upper bound for the average treatment effect is 0.67. The method fitpredict produces the estimated individual treatment effect. If the confidence interval for the individual treatment effect is needed, we can use bootstrap by specifying the bootstrap number, bootstrap size, and setting return psi equals true. The output gives us both the estimated individual treatment effect and the estimated upper and lower bound for each individual. In step 4, we will talk about how to use base T regressor with the light GBM model for the T-Learner. Base T regressor is a generalized method that can take in existing machine learning models from packages such as Sclearn and XGBoost and run T-Learners with those models. In this step, we will run the base T regressor with LGBM regressor. If we run base T regressor with XGBoost, the result is the same as the XGBT regressor that comes with the CausalML Python package. To estimate the average treatment effect using base T regressor, we first initiate the base T regressor with the LGBM regressor, then get the average treatment effect and its upper bound and lower bound using the estimate8 method. We can see that the estimated average treatment effect is 0.58, which is 0.08 higher than the true average treatment effect. The lower bound for the average treatment effect is 0.54 and the upper bound for the average treatment effect is 0.62. The confidence interval range is smaller than the confidence interval from the built-in XGBT regressor. The results show that using the base S regressor in combination with LGBM regressor produced a better estimation for the average treatment effect than the built-in XGBT regressor. To estimate the individual treatment effect, we use the method fitpredict on the light GBM model. We can also use bootstrap by specifying the bootstrap number, bootstrap size, and setting return psi equals true to get the estimated individual treatment effect and the estimated upper and lower bound for each individual. In step 5, we will talk about how to use a neural network model with T-Learner. The Python package CausalML has a built-in function MLPT regressor that runs the multilayer perceptron neural network models with T-Learner. Hidden layer sizes specifies the number of hidden layers and the number of neurons in each layer. Hidden layer sizes equals means that there are 4 hidden layers for the neural network model. The first hidden layer has 35 neurons, the second hidden layer has 25 neurons, the third hidden layer has 10 neurons, and the fourth hidden layer has 5 neurons. Learning rate, and it specifies the initial learning rate of the neural network model. we set the initial value to 0.01. Early stopping equals true means the neural network model stops training if the model loss does not improve. Random state gives us reproducible results. After initiating the neural network model using MLPT regressor, we gave it a name in N and run estimate 8 on it to get the average treatment effect, and the upper and lower bound of the average treatment effect. We can see that the estimated average treatment effect is 0.58, which is 0.08 higher than the true average treatment effect, and the same as the light GBM results. Tuning the hyperparameters such as the number of layers, the number of neurons in each layer, and the initial learning rate can potentially improve the model performance. Calculating the individual treatment effect for the neural network model is the same as other T-learner models. We use the method fit predict on the neural network model to get the individual treatment effect. We can also use bootstrap by specifying the bootstrap number, bootstrap size, and setting return psi equals true to get the estimated individual treatment effect, and the estimated upper and lower bound for each individual. In step 6, we will talk about how to get feature importance for T-learner. The syntax for getting the feature importance is the same for any modeling algorithm. We will use the neural network model as an example to illustrate the process. The feature importance is calculated by building a new machine learning model on the backend, where the dependent variable is the individual treatment effect, and the independent variables are the features of the model. Get importance is the function to get the feature importance values. X takes in the feature matrix. Tau takes in the individual treatment effect. Features equals feature names prints out the feature names in the outputs. Random state makes the results reproducible. Method specifies whether to use auto or permutation for the feature importance calculation. Auto works on a tree-based estimator. It uses the estimator's default feature importance. If no tree-based estimator is provided, it falls back to the LGBM regressor, and gain is the importance type. Permutation works on any estimator. It permutes a feature column and calculates the decrease in accuracy. The feature importance is ordered based on the magnitude of the decrease in accuracy. When the sample size is large, downsampling is suggested. From the output, we can see that X2 is the most important feature. X5 is the least important feature. We can also visualize the feature importance using the plot importance function. In step 7, we will interpret the T-learner model using SHAP. The syntax for SHAP interpretation is the same for any modeling algorithm. We will use the neural network model as an example to illustrate the process. The sharply values are calculated based on a machine learning model, where the dependent variable is the individual treatment effect and the independent variables are the features of the model. Plot SHAP values is the function to visualize SHAP values. X takes in the feature matrix. Tau takes in the individual treatment effect. Features equals feature names prints out the feature names in the outputs. The SHAP plot includes both the feature importance and the feature impacts. The y-axis is the list of features ordered from the most important to the least important. The x-axis is the SHAP value, representing how each feature impacts the model output. The color of the dots represents the feature values. Blue indicates low values, and red indicates high values. The overlapping dots are jittered, which helps us to see the distribution of each feature. For example, from the SHAP plot we can see that X2 is the most important feature. High X2 values affect the predictions in a positive direction, and low X2 values affect the predictions in a negative direction. Most samples have high X2 values. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about the Uplift models, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.